In this video, we will solve one more problem, that is determine IL. IL is the current passing through the inductor. So we have two voltage source, one is 10 volt, another one is 20 volt, but it's multiplied by U of t. 20 is multiplied by U of t. That means this voltage source will be active only t greater than 0. When t less than 0, it is inactive. Inactive means its value will be 0. So that means this voltage source can be considered as a short circuit for t less than 0. For t greater than 0, this will have 20 volt. And we have IL, and current direction is like this, and 50 ohm resistance and 1 millifarad capacitance, and voltage across that is Vc. And question is, you have to find IL. So first we will find for t less than 0, this 10 volt battery will be there, so that is 10, but this 20 U of t will be absent. So its absent means here its value will be 0, that is short circuit. And we have one inductor and resistor and capacitor. Okay. And this value is 15.625, and current passing through IL 51 milli. This is Vc. Okay. This is t less than 0. For t greater than 0, this 20 volt come into picture. So you can see here, when that voltage source is also present, this is minus this side, plus this side. So we have two voltage source, inductor, resistor and capacitor. So this value is 10, this value is 20, and this is 15.625, 51 milli, and voltage across this is Vc, and current this one is IL. So for this circuit itself, first we will determine whether it is series RLC or parallel RLC. Method is, you have to deactivate for t greater than 0. For that circuit, you deactivate all the independent sources. We have two independent sources. You deactivate them. Deactivate means voltage source value will be 0. So these two will be 0, 0 means this will be short circuit. Now remaining is inductor in parallel with the resistor, in parallel with capacitor. So if these two are short circuit, RLC, what we are getting is the parallel circuit. So we can just write it is parallel RLC network. Okay. And t greater than 0, we have a independent sources here. That means it is a driven RLC. So in the previous problem, we solved driven series RLC. Now we will solve driven parallel RLC. Okay. So step one. So what you have to do in the first step, you have to calculate first alpha. Alpha is 1 by 2 RC. Formula here, 1 by 2 RC. If it is a series, it will be R by 2 L. So if you substitute, you will get 10. 10 you will get. And omega naught, if you substitute, it is 1 by root LC. You will get value 8 radian per second. Okay. So alpha and omega naught value we have found. So if you compare now, alpha is greater than omega naught, so response will be overdamped response. So overdamped response, we have to find S1 and S2. S1 is minus alpha plus alpha square minus omega naught square, that is minus 4. S2 is minus alpha minus alpha square minus omega naught square, that is minus 16. So that is about the step 1. Step 2, so we have to calculate. In the step 2, we have to calculate initial conditions. Okay, so initial condition means, in step 2, we will just find IL of 0 minus and VC of 0 minus. So let me copy this. Okay, so here we have to find IL of 0 minus. At t equal to 0 minus, this inductor will act like a short, so and this capacitor will act like a open circuit. Remaining in the circuit is 10 volt battery and 50 ohm resistance. So what is the current flowing through inductor, that is IL? That is nothing but 10 by 50. So it is IL of 0 minus is equal to 10 volt divided by 50 ohm, that will be 0.2 ampere. Okay, so that is IL of 0 minus. And if you consider IL of 0 plus is equal to IL of 0 minus, that will be 0.2 ampere. Okay, now VC of 0 minus we have to calculate. At t equal to 0 minus, this capacitor will be open, this inductor will be short. So if you can find out voltage across this resistor, that will be the voltage across this capacitor. Okay, so that is VC of 0 minus is nothing but 10 volt. You can see here this, the voltage, so voltage across this capacitor is nothing but the voltage across this resistor, that is VC, that is 10 volt. VC of 0 plus is equal to VC of 0 minus equal to 10 volt. So 10 volt is the voltage across the capacitor. That is step 2. So step 3, we have to find ILF, because finally the question is what, get an expression for IL. So in the step 3 we will find ILF. It is also known as IL of infinity. So what is the DC steady state current, IL? Okay, so if you again consider this circuit, that is t greater than 0, so I will copy that and paste. If you paste here, copy and paste here. So now at t, IL of infinity, if it is kept for long period of time, so what will happen, this again inductor will act like a short and capacitor act like a open. So what is the current flowing through this inductor? This voltage, they are in series, so 30 volt, and this will be open, so only 50 ohm and 30 volt will come into picture. So totally ILF or IL of infinity, so that is nothing but 30 volt divided by 50. Okay, so it is nothing but 0.6 ampere. This is IL of F. So final value through this inductor will be 0.6 ampere. Okay, that is step 3. So step 4, in the complete response, that is IL of T, we have one part that is force response and another part we have natural response. And force response we already calculated, that 0.6, but natural response we have to calculate. So IL of T, force response is 0.6, natural response, since the response is overdamped response, you will get this form, that a1 e power s1 of t plus a2 e power s2 t. So this form you will get, okay? So now from the initial condition, we already calculated IL of 0 plus or IL of 0. That is nothing but 0.2. So that you equate to this equation with the t equal to 0. That is 0.6 plus a1 plus a2. So that will give one equation, a1 plus a2 equal to minus 0.4. So that will give one equation. So that is step 4. Step 5, we have to find one more equation now. So that can be easily found by differentiating dIL by dt and equating t equal to 0. That is nothing but VL of 0 plus by L. If it were VC, then we would have done VC, dVC by dt equated to IC of 0 plus by C. Now it is dIL by dt, it will be equal to VL of 0 plus L. So if you differentiate this one, this equation you have to differentiate. So if you differentiate that one, 0.6 differentiate, that is 0. So a1 s1 plus a2 s2, that will be equal to VL of 0 plus divided by L. Okay. So a1 of s1 and a2 of s2, s1 and s2 value we already know that. So what is that s1 s2? Let me see that. S1 s2 minus 4 and minus 16. Okay. So we know those two values. So it is minus 4 a1 minus 4 a1 and minus 16 a2, that equal to VL of 0 plus divided by L. Okay. Now only remaining is we have to find this VL of 0 plus. So what is that circuit? For that we will draw at t equal to 0 plus what is the equivalent circuit. So that we will draw first. What is that? One, we have 30 volt, that is 20 plus 10. I'm writing together, it is 30 volt. And you have an inductor and resistor and capacitor. Okay. So at t equal to 0 plus, this can be modeled as a current source, and capacitor can be modeled as a voltage source. So this voltage, we already know this one. So this can be modeled as a voltage source. So that value we already know that. What is that value? So VC of in step 2 we calculated VC of the 10 volt. It is 10 volt. So that one is 10 volt. Okay. And this can be modeled as a current source. The IL direction is this one. Of what value? This IL is 0.2 ampere. Okay. So we have to find what is VL. So IL direction is this one. This is the IL direction. It is flowing like this. So this will be VL. We will take plus this side, minus this side. So VL. So you have to find VL of 0 plus you have to find. So we know VC of 0 plus, and you have to calculate VL of 0 plus. And this one is voltage across, this will be 10 volt. So we'll apply KVL and solve this one. So if you apply KVL like this, so this is minus 30 plus VL of 0 plus, and plus this one will be 10 volt, that is VC of 0 plus, that is 10 volt equal to 0. So VL of 0 plus is minus 30 plus and it's minus 20, and if you take this side, this will be 20 volt. Okay. So in this equation we will substitute. So in the above equation, if you substitute, it is minus 4a1 minus 16a2 equal to 20 divided by L. So L value we know that it is 15.625. okay. So you have one more equation. This is equation 2. Equation 1 we had there, that is a1. Equation 1 is a1 plus a2 equal to minus 0.4. So if you solve these two equation, you will get a1 you will get. So a1 value will be minus 0.4226 and a2 value will be +0.0266. So complete response, if you write IL of t is ILF, ILF plus ILN. So where that ILF we already know it is 0.6, and ILN it is A1. A1 is -0.4226 into e power minus S1t. S1 is 4t plus A2, that is 0.0266, and e power minus 16t. So this is the response.